What is a pump? What does it do? Basically, a pump converts electrical energy into mechanical energy, which in turn raises the pressure of a fluid. The rotation of the pump pulls fluid into the eye of the impeller, and using centrifugal force, increases the fluid velocity, converting the static head at the inlet into velocity head in the impeller. Upon leaving the impeller, this velocity head is then converted in the diffuser back into static head, but at a much higher outlet pressure. The higher pressure fluid at the exit of the pump will naturally or automatically flow through the pipe in the direction of lower pressure. If the system is a closed loop, it will find its destination back at the suction of the pump. This graphic shows what's called an end suction pump. It has this name because the fluid is pulled in axially from the end of the pump or in the same direction as the pump shaft. Also, note that this is a single suction pump, meaning fluid enters through only one port. There are many categories of pumps, and there are many design variations within those pump categories. However, let's focus on three or four of the most commonly used in chilled water, condensed water, and hot water systems. Most pumps used in HVAC are of centrifugal type. One of the most common is the base or frame-mounted end suction pump. With this pump, there is a frame upon which the motor and pump are mounted, and both shafts are connected by a coupling, which makes servicing the equipment much easier. Then there's close-coupled pumps. Visually, they look similar to the frame-mounted type, except for they have one solid shaft that the pump and motor share, meaning there's no coupling. These pumps are nice in that they take up less space, but they can be challenging to service and make replacements more costly, not to mention they're typically a higher first cost. For these reasons, the previously discussed pump type is more common. Inline pumps are a very attractive option when space is in short supply. Inline pumps are installed directly in the piping, so suction and discharge are both axially positioned with the pipe, meaning it looks like you could just cut out a section of straight pipe and insert the pump. Another popular pump in HVAC is the double suction pump. These pumps draw fluid in from the sides or perpendicular to the shaft and are generally more efficient than single suction pumps. They're larger and more heavy duty and accordingly come at a higher first cost. Thus, they're utilized more often when flow rates are high, or exceeding 4,000 GPM, or 250 liters per second. Finally, there's the vertical turbine type pump. You might recognize these from the sump pump in your house. That's because it's used in applications when a submersible pump is needed. Some are fully submersible, but most used in HVAC are found with just the pump portion being submersed. In other words, everything but the motor. These pumps are used whenever the NPSH, or net positive suction head available, is very low, and typically only in condenser water or open cooling tower systems that utilize a sump tank as shown here. Then, when this pump type is applied, the designer must be careful to ensure the water level remains between the specified minimums and maximums to avoid potential issues.
York, high performance environments for life.